might say, why is it that African leaders haven't done anything about this deplorable situation? Well, let me tell you, my brother and sister, they have tried. Documented to this day, 22 coups where leaders were assassinated. France had something to do with it. The first seven, when they decided they were pulling out of the CFA and that they're going to print their own money, they were assassinated. Every time an African leader has tried to do what's best for their country, they were assassinated. Majority of them aided by France. It's a known fact. And then others, they were just mercenaries who felt that when there was a natural resource discovered in one country, they wanted to create a coup. So while the country is thrown into a civil war, they're siphoning the natural resource. We know of one particular story that had we not known about it, it would have been, oh, there we go again, the Africans. In about 25 years ago, a group of young, rich, white kids were having fun in Cape Town. They found out that there was oil in Equatorial Guinea that just been discovered, and they wanted it. So they set out a plan to have a coup in Equatorial Guinea. So while the Guineans are busy fighting a civil war, they will be siphoning the oil. But they made one mistake. There were two planes. One was to leave South Africa, stop in Zimbabwe, pick up more ammunition on their way to hunt in Equatorial Guinea. Another plane was taking off in the Caribbean that had this puppet diaspora who was supposed to be the next president. Mugabe wondered why such young people needed such powerful ammunition to go hunt in Equatorial Guinea. In doing his research further, he found out that this was a coup in the making. He allowed them to land in Zimbabwe. They loaded their plane, and just before takeoff, they were all arrested. The ringleader of that group was none other than the son of the former Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, Margaret Thatcher. She had to fly to Zimbabwe and paid handsomely to get her son out. The last one of those prisoners left Zimbabwe about 6-7 years ago. Had these young people succeeded, it would have been another coup. There you go, the Africans again. Such, my brothers and sisters, is the story of your Africa. They don't do coups anymore. They simply create instability. So when you hear of an instability in an African country, ask yourself, what is really going on? Because what they are telling you is really going on is just a shiny object. The real issue is over here. And you need to stop before you start being used as an instrument of your own self-destruction.
And that is the most unique thing that we have as Gambians. Like, we interact with one another, we live with one another. It doesn't matter how big the family is. We share everything, no matter how little it is. And people are content with that. That even if things are going hard, you can still observe smiling faces on the each and every person that you meet along the street. So that is a plus for everybody in the Gambia. And that is why I'm a proud Gambian and a proud African. And I believe I can make it. And I'm going nowhere but in the Gambia. Nobody is going to do it for us.
That's right.
If we are all running away, you know, when are we going to make it? We have to stay in Africa, develop in Africa, and then show to the world that Africa have a better image than the one they portray in the West. I think this is what we all need to do as Africans, and then we promote that as Pan-Africans and also as Gambians.
Excellent. I couldn't have said it better myself, actually. You know, I propose that you come and do some shows with me. This brother's got it going on. Yeah. But seriously, you know, I think that the misrepresentation of Africa has, wow, I mean, it permeated my brain. And I knew because I was coming from a Pan-African background, but still, you know, the images are forced upon us. So I think you young Gambians have a responsibility to show the other side of Gambia, the Gambia that, you know, we diasporians and many people in the West don't see. They just don't see it.
Exactly. I think that is the work of the academics. That is the work that we need to do as young scholars. For far too long, people have been portraying Africa negatively to the outside world. And we know that that was done by individuals whose sole aim was to dominate Africa, to exploit Africa's resources, and then to continue to colonize us politically. Now, our role as academics, as young scholars, is how do we make sure that this picture is changed from the literature itself, going back to rewrite the books, to rewrite the history of Africa, and then to show to the world that we have a better image that the world is actually seeing as of today. And then you also come to realize that we need to invest in Africa, because foreign investment always leads to capital flies and etc. Because people who come in and invest, at the end, they can take all the resources, and then you come to realize that it becomes another challenge for us. But when Africans invest, the money stays in Africa, which is a plus. It can enhance, it can help when it comes to employment, when it comes to, you know, coming up with all the facilities and then enhancing the development that we own, that we all desire as Africans and etc. I think that is what we need to do as we speak, and that is what we all Africans need to be thinking into that particular line, like trying to see how we can repent that particular picture shown by the outsiders about Africa. Because they, in fact, let me tell you, that was this quotation that I read. It was actually done by a British parliamentarian, Lord Macaulay, in 1835. He speaks about Africa, and then he said, in order for the West to dominate Africa, they need to overthrow our very backbone, and that is our education system. When we believe that everything that is Western is correct, then they can dominate us forever.
Exactly.
And that is 1835. They've been working on those bases. So today it is high time, because we know the realities. Let us try to rewrite the history. Let us try to work again and attract investment in Africa.